done is I've looked around for different tour providers, and I'm pleased to say I've found CitizenLink, and it's a company based out of California. And I actually went to the conference for chamber professionals, and Peter will tell you that they're the number one provider for chambers of commerce for travel to China. They've had, I think it's tens of thousands of people that you've taken on these trips.
We took 20,000 people every year.
20,000 people every year to China. So they're very seasoned in this whole industry and what they do, and you see the itinerary. So it's our first effort to work with a company like this, so we're excited, and I think we're equally excited by the number of people that have expressed an interest, because we think the price is really good, mm-hmm. and I think the quality of the trip is also excellent. So what I'm going to do is let Peter Liu go forward and do his presentation, and if you have any questions, we'll field those.
Hello. I'm very excited to be here. Very good weather, spring break. My name is Peter Liu, L-I-U. I'm working for the company CitizenLink, C-I-T-S-L-I-N-C. All the chamber tour from North America done by our company. If you heard about the Dallas-Fort Worth have a chamber tour to China, it's done by us as well. All the chamber of commerce use us. I've been to all the 15 US states, all the 10 Canada provinces. The far north Peter travel is Yellowknife, almost in the Arctic Circle. Far east I travel is Songjiang, Newfoundland. July 1st, it snowed on me 2 times. Songjiang. If you've ever been to Songjiang, you know Peter was there. And then we do the trip. The first time the chamber trip, it happened 1999. They celebrate of New Year of 2000 on the Great Wall. Everybody enjoy the beautiful view there, see the white Great Wall, everybody happy, but they think that is too cold. That's why we do the tour. After that, we do the tour only 2 seasons, spring and the fall. So we think the spring and the fall is 2 best seasons to visit China. Not very hot, not very cold, okay? The spring season is the end of February, every day in March and early April. The fall season is every day in October and early November. Everybody come back before American Thanksgiving. So that is the tour. All the tour we do, 7 nights, 9 days trip. What means 7 nights, 9 days? You have more days, so you guys have to fly to JFK. Starting from JFK is the part of V2. From here to JFK, your chamber arranged. So from JFK to China, come back from JFK is all company's job, okay? So 7 nights, 9 days. What means 7 nights, 9 days? That means if you leave on a Friday, you come back next Saturday. The city we do, 4 cities. In China, Beijing, Shanghai, Suzhou, and Hangzhou. Beijing, you will be there for 3 nights. 1 night in Suzhou, 1 night in Hangzhou, and 2 nights in Shanghai. I think all of us know Beijing, right? The capital of China, holding the 2008 Summer Olympic. The Great Wall there, Forbidden City there, Tiananmen Square there, Ming Tong, Temple of Heaven, Summer Palace, that is all in Beijing, okay? And also, you all take a picture of the bird net water cube from 2008 Summer Olympic. We might reuse that 2 stadium for the Winter Olympic 2022. If you have a good time for this tour, 2022, you will come back to join us for the Winter Olympic. You know how good we do for the Summer Olympic, the opening and the closing ceremony. Maybe you want to see that in person. Beijing will be the only city in the history holding the both Summer and the Winter Olympic. So that's something very unique. You can tell your friends that you are there before in the stadium, okay? And Shanghai, majority of all people we know Shanghai as well. Shanghai is the economic capital of China, like New York City to America. So their stock market in Shanghai. The famous picture about the Shanghai, you see all the Shanghai skylines, one look like a bottle opener, one Oriental TV tower. So that everything we built within 35 years. 35 years ago is all farmland. You know how fast China developed? 35 years ago, when I was a kid, my mom only make $5 a month. 22 years ago, When I, 1996, October 24th, I went to America. My mom only make $50 a month. Nowadays, the city, they make $500 to $800 per month. So that's how fast China grew. So in my imagination, when I was a kid, I said, if I earn $150, I will be rich. So now we all earn more than $150. So it's better than the Chinese people's dream. So every time you go to China, something new happened with me. Every half year, I go to China with a group. So even something for me is very new. So now, if you have the WeChat Pay, Alipay, you can use phone. You don't even have any cash. As long as your phone has battery, you can pay for your bus ticket, you can pay something. So very interesting for you go to China. No matter how hard you think about China, you think it wrong. This is a bit different than you expected. Okay? And Suzhou and Hangzhou is two new cities for you. Okay? They said, the Chinese people said, up there is the heaven, down is Suzhou and Hangzhou. Suzhou and Hangzhou is two beautiful cities, can compete with heaven. Suzhou is famous for the Chinese silk, S-I-L-K, silk product. In China, 70% of Chinese silk from the Suzhou neighborhood. Okay? And also, Suzhou is famous for the Chinese silk garden. If you ever went to Metropolitan Museum in New York City, on the second floor, they have a Chinese garden. Every part, every plant, every stone shipped from Suzhou. When we mean the Chinese garden, other than the Royal Garden in Beijing, we mean the Suzhou Silk Garden. There are four most famous private gardens in China. Three of them located in Suzhou, one located in Shanghai, still Suzhou Silk Garden. You will visit one of my favorite places in China, the Lingering Garden. You can be there for days. Each window you look out is a different picture. And also, you can see the 500 years old bonsai tree, which is very amazing to be there. Because think about 500 years old, we take care of the tree. If anybody didn't do a good job, the tree died, you know, before we see them already. So we all, you know, do a, you know, very good job, keep the tree alive for 500 years. Okay. And also, another name for Suzhou is Venice of the East. Venice of the East. Okay. And then you have a lot of river in town. You can do an optional tour for $29 to a boat ride on the Grand Canal. You see, Grand Canal is the longest man-made river on Earth. 1,000 miles long, 1,000 years old. You might see a bridge, 700 years old. You see a house on the bank, maybe 400 years old house, something, yeah. And then Hangzhou, number one desirable vacation place for the Chinese people. On the one Chinese money bill on the back, that is sightseeing three statues from West Lake. Even Dragon Lady enjoy West Lake. They ask worker to build a man-made lake in the summer palace. The Kunming Lake is a copy of the West Lake from Hangzhou. And Hangzhou also number one Chinese green tea place called the Dragon Well. Emperor gave the name to the Dragon Well green tea. I promise you, much better tea than the Starbucks tea here. Number one Chinese brand, Dragon Well green tea. And you also in Hangzhou, you will see a temple, Suzhou Hangzhou, you see a temple there. See where Chinese people pray. Don't have to believe Buddhism, but seeing Chinese pray, very interesting. And also, you see 500 Buddha statue called 500 Lohan statues, lower level than a Buddha, 500, all different faces statues. And you also will see a Buddha, outside 13 story, inside 7 story. So that is our regular tour, 3400. You can pay $200 to see the Terracotta Warrior. You will not see Suzhou and Hangzhou. Day 5, when everybody fly from Beijing to Shanghai, bus ride 1.5 hour to Suzhou, you fly from Beijing to Xi'an to see the warrior area for 2 days. Day 7, you rejoin the group, fly to Shanghai, rejoin the group to see Shanghai. You will not see Suzhou and Hangzhou. If that is your first time to China, if Terracotta Warrior not on your bucket list, I promise you, $3,400 trip. As good as $3,600 trip you go to Xi'an. Suzhou and Hangzhou worth the money for you to visit. Okay? If you like our trip very much, why not next year join us again to China, still the warrior tour, okay? But I promise you, you will enjoy Suzhou and Hangzhou as much as you enjoy the Xi'an trip, okay? The smallest city in China, this time you visit, is Suzhou. Only 9 million people there. Too small, no airport there. That's why day 5 you have to fly from Beijing to Shanghai, bus ride 1.5 hours to Suzhou. Day 6, from Suzhou to Hangzhou after the tour, about 2.5 hours bus ride. Day 7, from Hangzhou back to Shanghai, about 3 hours, 3.5 hours bus ride. Any bus ride more than 2 hours, they will stop one time, let you to encounter the Chinese restroom. Why Peter mentioned Chinese restroom? Chinese restroom, like your camping trip, have a hole on the ground. It's very hard, they aim hard to get there. Yeah. Lucky you, after the Olympic, prepare the Olympic, we rank our restroom. When you see a 5-star on the restroom, like the restroom here, like the captain hotel I stay, Peter stays, you know, there. You will enjoy the 5-star restroom to use. All the hotel, even the 4-star hotels, have the 5-star restroom. You can pass the restroom. Okay? But the best restroom in the sightseeing place, only 4-star. What means 4-star? Still Western style. Still hot water to wash your hand. Still air conditioned. Only difference between a 4-star to a 5-star, no toilet paper. Yeah, so somebody said you went to China before, right? And the 4-star restaurant. He already said Peter is right, okay? Somebody approved Peter is right. So, first thing you do after you check in the hotel, run to your hotel restroom, get a half full. Put it with you. I'm very serious, okay? Don't think that is a joke, okay? I'm very serious. Don't call us emergency contact number. Hey, Peter, deliver me 3 toilet paper. I promise you, I will charge you big money every day. Yeah? So, 3-star restroom, you may not enjoy that much. You still can use it. 1-star, 2-star, you let Peter know if you enjoy it or not. But for all American people or Canadian people, I don't know you, after 5 days, they can use whatever available here. So we learn very fast. I'm very, you know, proud of them. But I probably you will be good as well, okay? But even the 1-star, 2-star, they have a disabled restroom. Like handicap, they call it disabled, like handicap restroom. You can sit down to use. First 5 days, everybody waiting in line. After 5 days, it's okay. You can use it. Anyway, I will show you can you help me to show the video?
Yeah.
I will show you a video from the real group, not taken by Peter, taken by the real passenger just like you. Okay, our company name is CITS-Link, China International Travel Service, CITS name. Your friend didn't come over today, you can go home to watch the video. CITS-Link.org, same video. Typical airplane we use, Boeing 777 or Airbus A330. More than 300 people on board. That flight, they only have 80 seats for you. That flight only have flight more than 300 people, we only have 80 seats for that flight. But we can open another flight. That same day or one day later, one day early. That is the typical hotel breakfast. I showed you the hotel room already there. Hotel breakfast. CITS-Link, we pay more than $25 for your breakfast. Anything you can imagine is there for your breakfast. We recommend you eat as much as you could for your breakfast. Lunch and dinner will be the traditional Chinese food. Party of 10 share people. Typical lunch and dinner could be shrimp, fish, pork, chicken, beef, vegetable, tofu or something. 7 dishes for you to share. First few days, you enjoy the Chinese food. After 9 days, they come back. half year, no Chinese food. Number one complaint we have is too much Chinese food in China. What a surprise. Sorry, the video very small. If you care about the Chinese food, we do have a McDonald's, Burger King, KFC, TGI Friday, Papa John Pizza, Pizza Hut, Caesar, Hard Rock Cafe, even Hooters in both in Beijing and Shanghai. And if you care about Chinese food, I'll say, oh, I have a friend of three. I want to go to together, go to Hooters, take my picture, enjoy Hooters, you know, hot name. Good for you, good choice. China have less criminal rate than Americans and Canada. But, oh, sorry, very fast, the Mewtwo, that's the Mewtwo section. China have a less criminal rate than Americans and Canada, but we don't know where the good neighborhood, where the bad neighborhood. That's why three or four person, you make your small group, you go out together. Leave your very expensive jewelry home, that's jade factory. Teach you how to carve the jade, how to identify the hard jade to the jade dye, okay, the regular jade. And you know, some people take a 4-carat diamond ring to China. Even Peter like it. Okay. Put a diamond inside. Great wall. Climb up is easier. Climb down is harder. Make sure you can come back before you go up. Summer Palace. I told you that is a lake, a copy of the West Lake from Hangzhou. That's the Kunming Lake in Summer Palace. Dragon Lady used our Navy fund to build a Summer Palace. That's why we lost war with Japan. But at least we have a beautiful park after that. Do you see what they dress? What you should dress? The Beijing, the weather like New York City. Okay? Dressing in layers. I'm worried about you. Okay? You know, last time I told them October never snow. 1 year October didn't snow. People from Canada, oh, we enjoy the white Great Wall. People from Florida, they are treated to death. So I worry about you. That is an optional tour for $39. You go to visit the local family. Even Obama's wife takes two kids to visit the local family, have lunch there. It's some people say the best meal for the whole trip. They live there for more than 600 years already. Hutong, H-U-T-O-N-G. I want you to do a research on the Discovery Channel. That was 30 minutes video. You will appreciate where do we take you to. People live there for a long, long time already. Do you see what they dress? Take a very light sweater with you, take a jacket with you, lady in blue jeans, very comfortable, a comfortable walking shoes. No high heels when you climb the wall. High heels will help you climb the wall. You can never climb back. Casual dress. Comfortable walking shoes. Don't try the new shoes on the group. New shoes will hurt you. Tiananmen Square is that they can put 1 million Chinese people there. Under the Chairman Mao's picture, you enter the Forbidden City. I want you guys to see the movie, Last Emperor. After you see the movie, you know where to be take you to. The brick Emperor walked it on 500 years ago. You walked on the same brick. Real history. See the brick already wear out. The real history, The Peking duck dinner include. So my favorite dish in China, the Peking duck dinner. You see all the seniors, they are in the park to play. Okay? The park like their senior center. Because they don't have a big house like you, they all live in the condominium. So the Chinese senior enter the park for free. So they are why? They are the ballroom dancing, play Tai Chi or the same club, dancing club. You can join them for the ballroom dancing if you wish. The computer is very slow, I don't know why. Maybe the internet. The Marriott Hotel, Capital Hotel, we stay in Beijing. Okay, Marriott Hotel. Oh, that is my favorite place in China, the Lingering Garden. I told you, the four most famous permanent garden in China, the Lingering Garden. Each window you look out, a different picture. The 500 years old bonsai tree there. the reflection and everything. Do you have some Chinese people dancing or performance there? Yeah, dress traditional Chinese clothes. 500 years old bonsai tree. Silk factory. Teach you how to get the silk from a cocoon. One cocoon can get you 1 mil long silk. And then for the two worm living in one cocoon, we cannot find a front. That's why we make a silk blanket. Very good, very best buy for the trip. $110 get a king size silk blanket. Sometimes people buy the wrong size. Don't tell them a king size, queen size. Tell them how many centimeter long, how many centimeter wide. Buy the correct size for yourself. $110, very, very reasonable price. That is a $29 optional tour. You see the Grand Canal. See, I didn't shoot the video by purpose. That day is raining. It's not a raining season, but it might, could be rain. If you have a light raincoat, you're welcome to take this view. If an umbrella, not necessarily. During the rain, Chinese people were selling the umbrella $2 to $3. But $2 to $3 umbrella only working for 2 to 3 days. You can see the tea plantation. They have a tea plantation. That is the best green tea in China. The Dragon Veil green tea. Okay, there's a temple. Chinese go there to pray. You see the Chinese pray. Very interesting. I'm very sorry for the poor quality for the video. Huh? Not supposed to be like that, but we thank you for understanding. I mean, do you guys all follow Peter's Chinese English?
Yeah, but
I'm very glad it worked. Let us please get you on the one Chinese money bill. I want you to take a picture of this one Chinese money bill with that three statue on the best list. You know, tell your friend you've been there, you know, one Chinese money bill. Yeah. Shanghai skyline. Shanghai have more taller buildings than New York City now. Tabiao Hotel, you see, Renaissance Hotel. The author of the video, Terrible Chinese Food, have a hamburger in the hotel. $25 like price here. The meat from Australia. All the Shanghai skyline we built within 35 years. Let's look, when I look at both openers here. This side of the city, this part, that side, old part, we call the Bond area. It used to be the British colony. All the British building, like Wall Street building on this side of the old buildings. A silk rug factory, okay, very pure art, like 10 months to 12 months for them to finish one piece. More than $10,000. It's a, you dare not walk on your silk carpet, it hang on the wall, museum. Garden Bazaar, you can buy anything, everything there. You can buy a $1 silk scarf. It's a cool gift for your neighbors. Not really silk, but look at the silk. It looks beautiful. Okay, you can see another optional tour, the Cirque du Soleil. Regular price $79. You get a group discount of $39. You see, 8 motorcycle come out from the big cage. So, unbelievable job they do. Okay? The end of the era show. $39. Okay, our company information, Notre Park. We are in there for more than 25 years already. Okay? Thank you. Sorry for the poor speed. I mean, probably go home, the speed will be faster. Okay, go back to my old thing. And, you know, I'm very glad you understand that Peter's poor Chinese English. Our tour guide speak better English than Peter. Okay? We all learn English in college for 4 years, at least 7 years in business. Very professional, very good. It will help you in any way they could. But you know, if you laugh at my poor English here today, I promise you I will laugh at you when you speak Chinese. We have a different tone. So that's why some of the words Peter can never pronounce right. Please forgive me. Okay, please forgive me. You learn Chinese, you know how hard Peter tried. You will know that, okay? But anyway, you can call our best customer from America in the 32 New York Chamber. They send more than 3,000 people from the 32 New York Chamber to China already. Our best customer in Canada is Sudbury. Send 400 people from Sudbury, more than 400 people. So our second best is Winnipeg. We send more than 300 people from Winnipeg chamber. Mm-hmm. I don't think you can beat America, let's beat Canada. Let's do 400 people from here. Okay, let's do it. And for that flight, for that particular flight, we have two flights a day leaving from JFK Airport to China we use. One called Air China, one called China Eastern Airlines. What's the difference between that two airlines? One home base in Beijing. So when you fly from JFK to Beijing nonstop, last day from Shanghai back, you fly back to Beijing first, leave over there 3 hours. Then you fly from Beijing to JFK nonstop. The other airline is called China Eastern Airline. They are home base in Shanghai. So when you fly to Beijing, you fly to Shanghai first, leave over there 3 hours, then fly to Beijing the first day. The last day you come back from Shanghai, nonstop flight. So no matter which airline do we choose for you, either on the way there to Beijing, you stop one time in Shanghai, or on the way back from Shanghai, you stop one time in Beijing. Another one is a nonstop flight. Do you guys follow Peter for this one?
Yes.
So for each flight, we only have 80 seats. We don't know, you know, you have that many people come over today. So we only have 80 seats reserved for your chamber at this moment. But the chamber can email our company, be whether or not we can get another flight for you, same date or 1 day early, 1 day later. So when you book with the chamber, let the chamber know who you want to share the bus with. Oh, who don't you want to We only put down 25 to 30 people per bus. You already saw the bus picture on the video. The bus look like a Greyhound bus here. 50 passenger tour bus, either made in China or made in Japan, for 50 Chinese figures. You know, the people size, North American people size like bigger, we only fit 25. We have some room for clothes. I mean, if you dress in layers, you can leave your jacket on the tour bus the whole day. You have the tour bus. Okay? So dress in layers, casual dress for the whole trip. I keep reminding you to, I really, really worry about your people from the source area. Okay? And also, this price based on two people share the room. You can either require one king size bed or two queen size bed. If you tell with the kids, we can give you the third bed to your room. Will be a rulerly bed. Peter can sleep on the rulerly. I cannot move around. If I move, I might fall down. We have a third bed for the kids only. If you have three adults in your group, you put a third adult name. We can let three of you share one room, but better put your name in the chamber. I looking for the roommate list. Mm-hmm. Chamber will assign you a same gender of travelers. Do something before the trip. See if you can get along with each other. Not all boxing, you know, 7 nights in China. Otherwise, you pay the single fee for $500 more. You have a room all for yourself. Okay? You can pay the, for the room. And before you go to China, we need to have a Chinese visa. They're changing the rule every day. No. So now we need the last month. The tour visa we apply for you only good for a month. So that means last month we need to apply the visa for you. So September 6th, the day, we might need all of you. We need your passport. We have to let the chamber mail all of your passport to us. The Chinese Consulate General in Los Angeles will double check your passport. They mail you back the same day after we let them see your passport. They mail you back after that day. So if you travel the last month, you have to get your own visa to China. Your own visa to China. Otherwise, we do a group visa the last month, either on the first day or the last day. I need your passport. So we will let the chamber know. If If you have to travel that month, I'm very sorry. The last month, we need to have your passport for one day to give to the Chinese Consul General. Then we mail you back by FedEx or by UPS. So that's something you need to have a Chinese visa. Not your visa card, a visa, a group visa of everybody in the month. It's very important. We need a Chinese visa to go to China. Your passport must be valid 6 more months, the time you come back from China. That means until next May, your passport is paired before next May, you have to have a new passport. Otherwise, we will not issue the group visa for you. So very important, you have your passport more than 6 months the time you come back from China. Even Peter, I used to be a Chinese citizen. I become American 6.5 years ago. I become the real Peter. My Chinese name is Liu Ping. We pronounce the family name first. Liu is my family, L-I-U, Liu. Ping like a ping pong, the first word of ping pong. So Liu Ping is my Chinese name. So I finally become Peter. Now, even me, I go to China, I need a Chinese visa. So all of us, we need a Chinese visa to go to China. I'm very sorry for this, something we have to do for you. So very important, when you register with the chamber, I need to get your name appear on your passport. No matter you like your name or not, we don't need your nickname. We need your real name appear on your passport. Does that make any sense to you? So yeah. It's very important, your passport name, okay? And also, the final payment date for you to the chamber is July 15th. For SysLink, chamber give us the money August 1st. Before August 1st, if you cancel, you only lost the deposit of $400. After August 1st, you will lost a lot of money. You know, for SysLink, we need to issue your ticket from JFK to China. That part you lost $500. Plus chamber ticket from here to JFK, non-refundable. Plus your visa fee after. So a lot of money for you. For you to protect yourself, I strongly recommend you buy the trip insurance from local travel agency. I don't know if you have a AAA. We buy the trip insurance. The American buy from a AAA or Canadian people buy from a CAA. I strongly recommend you buy the trip insurance. Why? I have a customer. You can call them. Their chamber, Concord, New Hampshire chamber, and the. He need a medical nurse accompany him back. He paid $8,000 to hire a nurse from US, fly to Beijing overnight with him, fly back from Beijing overnight to Concord, then nurse fly back to nurse hometown. So why you have to worry about $8,000 or more? So I strongly recommend, based on Peter's knowledge, I strongly recommend you buy the trip insurance. Clear? Okay, good. And after August 1st, we will issue everybody's airline ticket. So we need a month to issue everybody's airline ticket. The first week of September, which is 1 month before your trip, you will receive 5 things back from the Chamber of Commerce. What are the 5 things? You will receive the airline ticket. Airline ticket from us will be the group ticket. With everybody's name, like 25 of you name on, we have 25 circle on the bottom, the 25 ticket number. The ticket number also have your date of birth, also have your passport number, also have your male or female. Make sure it's all correct. Okay, we will double check before we give it to you. But sometimes the husband and wife, they backward you. So backward, so you put the wrong information. So sometimes we cannot find. You double check for me. So number one, match. Okay? If your information, make sure you is you. Your husband is your husband. So different person. Okay? Very important. Even 1 or 2 letter wrong with your name, you have to let us know. We let the airline know. Same person misspelled name. If your name totally misspelled, we might have to issue you a new airline ticket. Okay? You don't want to live with a panda the rest of your life. Give us a correct name. Double check and make sure all correct. Okay? Second one, they give you a final itinerary, like this itinerary here. More detailed information, what you will do every day. What's the, Oh, the Xi'an, yeah, okay, $200 more before this one. Okay, so, hotel phone number, hotel address, you know, all the hotel will be finalized. 1 month before your trip, all the hotel will be finalized. Also, we have that date, optional tour, how much the price, no hidden fees. So everything will be listed here. So how much, you know, how many optional tours there. I want you to read this paper, okay? This is a lot of optional tours. We officially only recommend you for two optional tours. Peter already mentioned to you. One, Hutong tour in Beijing, Hutong, H-U-T-O-N-G. The traditional Chinese neighborhood, they live there for more than 600 years. Hutong is a Mongolia word for narrow alley. The street is so narrow, our tour bus cannot drive in there. You only can do the rickshaw ride to the people's house have lunch there. Some people have the best meal for the whole trip, like mama, papa cook for you. They cook your decent meal in a 2 square meter kitchen. Peter cannot even turn in their kitchen. I'm the bad. Remember Peter said that. You are checking it yourself. That's $39. Another one is $29. You don't want the Grand Canal boat ride. Okay? But if you go to Xi'an, you will not see the Grand Canal boat ride. So that the Xi'an trip, you only have one you have to do it. Okay? If you have money left, the last day. Let's go to second page. Okay. The magnet train, 431 kilometers per hour, world faster train. That's something you might want to do. A round trip for $25, 270 miles per hour, $25. And also the era show. You know, regular price, I told you, $79. We get a good discount, $39. It's worth the $39 for you to do. Why Peter didn't mention the number two, the second, third one? The Legend of Kung Fu. Or we have the Peking Opera. I don't think your energy can do it all. You might snore there. After the Great Wall comes. Okay? So, next time, if you go to Broadway show, if two Chinese people snore there, you understand they from the trip. They have very long daytime trip already, so you forgive them. Okay, so you might do the same thing. That's why you might want to do some like a tailor-made clothes. The tailor can come over to your hotel, arranged by the tour guide. Be in Beijing, second night, 8 o'clock. The tailor come to your room, measure you. The gentleman can do a suit. For $300, lady can do a like a silk dress, Chinese traditional silk dress for $300. Well, 8 o'clock measure you. Following day, 7 p.m. 23 hours later, finish and measure you again. If you like, you pay cash, pay the credit card to buy your things. Or you want to do it after the Great Wall climbing, all the you know the long walk for the Forbidden City Tiananmen Square. You might do a food and a body massage for like $39, 1 hour and a half. Yeah, include the tips. Yeah, is that something? So that's why Peter didn't mention, oh, you have everybody have to do as a Legion of Kung Fu or Peking Opera. So you rather do a you know, massage, but make sure deep tissue. Not like the Swedish, it's like a tire, more hard. You try to, yeah, after the Great Wall, you might need it. So that is the optional tour. You pay additional US dollar to us, so make sure you read that. But this will be on your final itinerary list here, okay? And then, third thing we will give to you, we will give you an emergency contact number. Why you need a SysLink to go to China? They don't speak English or French. They only speak Mandarin, Chinese. That's why their 911 number not answer your English call. We will give you one number to answer all the emergency calls. If you want to know the hotel number, you want to know the tour guide number, you give that number a call. We will help you from there. So one number for everything. If you have trouble or if you cause trouble, the pharmacy will be there for you. Yeah? So that one number. people ask me, hey Peter, I have my cell phone number. I have my cell phone. Oh, I my cell phone not working in China. How do I call the emergency contact number? All the Chinese people have a cell phone. Okay, they will help you. So if you, for example, if you lost in the Forbidden City, there is a 9,999 half rooms there. If you your husband live with a group, you still draw a picture or take a picture of the entire furniture. But I want to make a similar design. I can sell it on Amazon or eBay. Okay, but good for you. But you lost your group. You burn in tears for half hours. You remember? Oh, have an emergency contact number. I find. So use your phone to call us. If you don't have a cell phone, no worry. Who do you ask for the Chinese for help? Which one you ask for help first? Police is the second choice. The first one is the other tour guide. The most of the other tour guides speak a little bit of English. They can help you. They're willing to help you. Why? They know how painful you are to lose your tour guide. They also know how painful your tour guide feels to lose you. Sometimes they lost one people or two. So that's why they are like run up and down if they know you leave the left of, they know your tour guide worry you very much. They are, let me help you. Let me put you back to the group. So if you lost, don't go very far. Stay where you lost. Try to find a tour guide first. If you cannot find a tour guide, find a park ranger dressed in uniform, stand like a tree, or the police officer. But they don't speak English. How do you communicate with them? The sign language do work. You cry first. Then you give the emergency contact number in his face for 3 minutes. They know. Call that number for you. Yeah, once they call us, she will tell me, hey, I have a big nose lady crying in front of me. Big nose. You have a little bit of bigger nose than the Chinese people. Chinese people, they even pay to do the plastic surgery, have a big nose like you. They even pay to do the white like you, the pearl cream. Or you guys want to be tan like them. The world is too wrong. Nobody can see. And then, once they call us, I said, okay, pass the phone to the big nose lady. I'm Lisa Huang from the Great Khmer Chamber of Commerce. I'm leaving from JFK Airport. Okay, I'm on the, what's your confirmation number? After you pay the deposit, Chamber will give you confirmation number. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we know who you are. So we know you not by your beautiful faces or your beautiful names. They can only know you by the chamber name and the confirmation number. I'm number one from Grand Cayman Chamber of Commerce. We know who you are. Okay, easy for me, easy for you. Okay, you let us know. I'm number three from the Grand Chamber of Commerce. I'm the name. I'm leaving from JFK Airport. I know who you are. Try to put you back to the group. Or in the hotel front desk people willing to help you call the emergency contact number. Okay, we are very serious for all emergency. Why chamber use Switzerland? We have a good reputation in the chamber's work. I personally lead the ACCE chamber president. So they have the national, US national chamber, Canada national chamber, CEOs, they go to China. I'm the leader for them. So that's why they trust us. We doing that many years. We try to help you the best we can do. Although, we will not help you pay the hospital bill. We will be there help you to figure it out and be back safely for the chamber next tour. I have a happy customer from Newport News, Virginia. You can call their chamber. One happy customer bring me 55 people for the next chamber tour. I don't think you have 55 friends, but you have 5 friends. Let's all go to China with us if you're happy this time. Okay? If you're happy, bring me 5 people, okay? And then, let's go back. So the number three, I call it, emergency contact number. Number four, we will give you a name tag. Your name ID, your confirmation number ID, your bus number. If you belong to bus one, never step a foot on bus two. We make color code of the bus. Bus 1 could be red, bus 2 could be green, bus 3 could be yellow. Red dot, yellow dot, name tag. We know which bus do you belong to. Okay? Tour guide speak good, very good English, but the bus driver don't speak English. If you don't want to be on bus 1, they won't allow you to come to bus 1. Name tag. Some people lost the name tag before they go to China. What a surprise. If you lost the name tag, you make me a name. I don't know if you have an office depot, home depot. Go to office depot, make me another name tag. Don't have to exactly like our name tag, but make sure you have a name tag. Very important, okay? You have a name tag, easy for us to know who you are. Easy for us to figure out you have a system group. Easy for everything, okay? Easy. Fifth thing we will give to you. We will give you 2 pieces of luggage tag. All the US airline, Canadian airline, only allow you 1 check-in luggage. All the Chinese airline allow you 2 check-in luggage. Why? They want you to support the Chinese economy. Bring more things back from China to US. Okay, that's why. Total weight for these 2 bags, 70 pounds.
Ooh,
70.
Wow.
Together, 1 people. The 2 bags, total weight, 70. If you only have 1, that is 50 pounds. 50 pounds. I strongly recommend you ladies travel light. Okay? Worry about you. You take 1 check-in luggage of 50 pounds, go to China. And also a carry-on luggage, smaller roller board can put on the bed of the airplane, okay? 1 check-in, 1 carry-on, go to China, easy, very easy for you. But you say, I want to buy this, I want to buy that. In Shanghai, you can buy a duffel bag, can put a half Peter inside. Only $20, even have a wheel on the bag, so you can check in. So ask the tour guide in Shanghai, where to get my duffel bag? I need that one, you know. Yes, I see some of you already know who needs to buy the duffel bag already. Yeah, okay. So, duffel bag, okay? And also, make sure you put some of the clothes in the carry-on. All ladies, you are too tall for the Chinese lady standards. So all the Chinese ladies want to take a picture of you. They are very tall. So you cannot find your clothes in China. Okay? That's why we prepared 2 or 3 days extra clothes in the carry-on luggage. Sometimes the big bag could be delayed. If your big bag is delayed, I don't want to smell on the tour bus. Otherwise, I'm hiding you a small corner of the tour bus on all the way to the back. Don't blame on Peter. I have to do that for us. Okay? Remember, Peter said 2 or 3 days carry-on luggage. You know, husband and wife, you can share a carry-on. So it's okay. 2 days, 3 days clothes, you can share a carry-on. So 1 carry-on is fine for you. And if you are on the prescription drugs, you can take like 2 times what you need. 1 put in the carry-on luggage, 1 put in the check-in luggage. No prescription marijuana. Illegal in China. Okay, I don't want you to get a call. You know, I have to help you. Anyway, so let's go back. 5 things the first week of September. Airline ticket. Make sure double check your name, your passport number, the date of birth, female or male, correct. Final itinerary, have your hotel phone number, hotel address, and also have the every day for the optional tours. Emergency contact number, very, very important, okay? I want you to get to the check-in place in JFK 3 hours or 3.5 hours before the flight time. You will need to be in the JFK check-in counter. You will first come, first serve, so select the city. If you go there last minute, you know what the United did to you? Beat you up and give you back. If the flight, I'm not against United, I'm the top player for United. So, things could happen. If you go there late, if the flight over soon, I'm sorry, you will miss Great Wall already. Okay, you want to be there early. 3.5 hours, 3 hours before, you go to check in, get your airline, the boarding pass. Okay. 4 things, name tag, very name tag all time traveling in China. 50, two login tag. Even if you have one login check in to go to China, you still get two login tag. You might want to buy something back. And also, what you can do, take some old clothes you want to throw away, make more room for your stuff. Some of my people take three pair of jeans, some short, you know, it's all good. Remember, people said, dress in layers, okay? Dress in layers. I worry about people from the source, always. And then, traveling day, so 3.5 hours before we check in, I mean, the flight time we check in. After we check in, we wait for a long time before we boarding the flight. The flight time from JFK Airport to Beijing, only 13 hours. Why Peter said only 13 hours? Peter flying from Los Angeles to Beijing, still 12 hours. That's why you are only 13 hours, so 1 hour extra. Why? You do a shortcut from the North Pole. You fly north instead of east or west. So you fly north. That's why you get there in 13. When you come back, 12 and a half. They fly back faster than 12 and a half hours. During a long 13 hours flight, and they will serve you two meals. They tell you one is dinner, one is breakfast. Peter cannot figure out which one is dinner, which one is breakfast. You serve you the same food. Airplane food, I'm sorry. During the long 30-hour flight, they will show you some, you know, English movie, I mean American Canadian movie with Chinese subtitle, or Chinese movie with English subtitle. Try to grab some Chinese word before you get there. During a long 30-hour flight, something from Peter's hometown, I encourage you to try it. The Chinese beer called Qingdao. We learned the brewery from Germany 100-some years ago. We used to be the colony of Germany. We know how to make beer. Two thumbs up for Qingdao beer. You ever drinking the Qingdao beer before? Chinese beer before? Any of you? You did? Okay. So very good. It's all soft drink. Very less alcohol. It's all soft drink. You are drinking beer all the time. Even you can brush your teeth with your beer. Very clean. If you are the wine drinker, I'm sorry to tell you the bad news. The best Chinese wine tastes like the best Italian vinegar. It's a very famous name called the Great Wall. Three thumbs down. If you are the wine drinker, starting from today, you switch to be a beer. In China, all hard liquors also very good. Like your moonshine, we call fire water. Yeah, you know, some of you know fire water. Consider 65% of pure alcohol. If your car no more gasoline, put the two bottles, drive yourself long way. Long Carmen Island, no problem. I mean, it's a cool gift to bring back for neighbors for, you know, for the year. It's burn. After drinking the fire water, help you climb the wall faster. Two thumbs up for fire water, two thumbs up for beer, three thumbs down for the wine. Good? And after the long 30-hour flight, if you are go to Beijing, we are there. If you go to Shanghai first, then we over there 3 hours, another 1 hour 45 minute flight from Shanghai to Beijing. We will see you guys in Beijing Airport. Probably Peter will welcome you guys in Beijing Airport. I'm one of the three tour managers. I take care of the emergency. Like I told you, Peter, will we see you? I said, if you have trouble or if you cause trouble, you might see me. If we no trouble that day, so I'm go to the airport, I bring a book for everybody's name. I check everybody's in, make sure you're all here. So check everybody's in. If you do see Peter there, wave to me, say hi. I will be very happy you know that's me. Right now, I'm the only Chinese in front of you. You know that is your Peter. And that time, after a long flight, you know, even I wave to you. I know that's me. Don't laugh, it could be you. Okay? So you You might want to take my picture. Let it all by Peter. I will be very happy to know that's me. Okay? All the tour guide, if you didn't see Peter there, I'm an emergency, or you didn't pretend you don't know me. See the other guy, including the sign. The bus one, bus two, pick you guys up from the airport. Okay? Tour guide will hold in the sign. Like I told you, tour guides speak very English and Peter can travel tour guide. One in Beijing, one in Shanghai. If you go to Xi'an, three tour guides. One Beijing, one Xi'an, one Shanghai. Okay? Okay. And if you forget your bus number, check on your name card. I'm very serious. Some people ask, like, oh, which bus do you belong to? Oh, oh. I said, okay, where is your name card? Oh, in the bag. Okay. So things could happen. You guys keep an eye. I mean, even we have an 80 people group, no worry. The people with you every day only on the people on your tour bus. So if a bus two have two people lost, it's bus two's problem. Bus one, all here, they go have a lunch every day. Bus two, have waiting for that two people. You keep an eye on the two people lost. Where are they? Next time, don't let them lost again. Otherwise, you'll be there. Good? Okay, good. And then, hotel, all hotel, I'm proud of all hotel. You can call the chamber I mentioned earlier, so call them. They will tell you the same thing. Everybody enjoy all hotel very much. And we have the 5-star hotel in Beijing or Shanghai, 4-star hotel, Suzhou, Hangzhou, and Xi'an. 5-star hotel like Marriott Hotel, Hyatt Hotel, Hilton Hotel, as good as the hotel in the States and here, okay? And then, in fact, in Beijing, we use 2 Marriott Hotel, 1 Renaissance Hotel, 1 Radisson, 1 Sheraton, 2 Crowne Plaza, and then we have a Shangri-La, Asian 5-star, very nice. And Shanghai, we have 3 Renaissance, 1 Marriott, 1 Sheraton, 1 Radisson, 1 Chinese 5-star hotel, still okay tonight. And then Suzhou, Hangzhou, like a Holiday Inn, not like Holiday Inn here, Holiday Inn like China, like 18, 19 story, more like a Crowne Plaza size. After we all check in the hotel by group check in, so you don't have to wait in line like Las Vegas, wait for like 2 or 3 hours to check in. We will check in, give you the room key either on the tour bus or in the lobby, we give you the room key. But we still need your passport. When you enter China, they give you a stamp on your passport. That stamp with your photo page, they need to scan in for the security reason for the hotel. So you can either wait there for your passport to be copied, or you can wait until tomorrow morning, the tour guide will give you back the passport. You can trust your tour guide or the front desk people with your passport. It's okay. Okay, then I don't want to trust anybody. We are there waiting for them to finish, and then give you back. Either way, it's okay to us. Clear? Okay. And then breakfast. I already show you on the video. Breakfast deluxe buffet breakfast. Seasoning paid more than $25 for your breakfast. We recommend you eat as much as you could. This is your only Western meal for that day. Lunch, dinner, traditional Chinese food, party of 10, share a table. Typical lunch and dinner, shrimp, fish, pork, chicken, beef, vegetable, 7 dishes for you to share. First few days, you enjoy the Chinese food. After 9 days, like I told you earlier, half year, no Chinese food. Number one complaint I already told you. What's the number one complaint? Too much Chinese food in China. Lunch and dinner, no dessert. When you see the watermelon come or orange come, and the fruit is their dessert. Okay? And so for your daily sugars, energy bars, vitamin bars, or cookie, whatever, you can take your own to China. Chocolate, M&M, okay? I remember Cambridge Chamber from Massachusetts, Harvard University area. The chamber president, she take 5 pounds of candy. Third day I saw her, she only have 2 pounds left. 25 of us, we eat 3 pounds of candy. All the candy Peter liked already gone. Okay, so be prepared. You can bring them a beef jerky mixed nut, share with your fellow travelers. And if you bring more than you can eat, You can give to the tour guide, give to Peter, give to bus driver. You're very happy. Give you a big smile.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. If you have the snackers for me. Okay.
Yeah.
And no fortune cookie in China. Fortune cookie from San Francisco called Chinatown. The 20 years Peter lived in China, they never eat fortune cookie. So don't ask for the fortune cookie. Okay? I'm very sorry to tell you. Yeah. And then another thing I want to share with you. In the morning, we leave the hotel 8 o'clock in the morning. That is after. Come back to the hotel 7 o'clock after, 7:30 after dinner. Although it's a long day, but from place to place, we're driving like 30 minutes, 45 minutes. You can rest on the bus, sleep a little bit, or listen to the tour guide give you more Chinese history, or they will give you a Chinese lesson. So it's also the very long. We have a lot of seniors in the group, no problem. You all can make it, no problem. But the thing is, no time for you to change every day. Don't take too much clothes. Yeah, in the morning, same clothes, at night, same clothes. No time for you to change.
Mm-hmm.
After 9 days tour, they call the chamber. Chamber, I need a vacation. We put on like 12 days tour in the 9 days itinerary. Every day, a lot of things for you to see. So you go to China not to rest. You go to China to see a lot of things, a lot of things, a lot of things. You can see a lot of people. Studio Suzhou, 9 million people. Hangzhou, 10 million people. Beijing, how many? 21, 22 million people. Shanghai, 23, 24 million people. I'm very sorry to tell you, you for the $3,400, you see a lot of people. And also, the hotel, even the five-star hotel, the tap water, you cannot drink it. You have to buy the bottle of water to drink. Or the hot tea, hot coffee is okay. You boil the water, you can drink it, no problem. Five-star hotel at a five-star price. Okay, so your Diet Coke in your refrigerator, $8.50. Next door, 7-Eleven, $0.50. Same Diet Coke. Okay, so yeah, five-star hotel at a five-star price. You know, that's why you need to change some Chinese money as well. So how much average people we take, how much cash to China? At least one master Visa credit card. And then we recommend $500 to $600 cash. First, you need to join us for the optional tour. And also, TIPS gratuity is $39 per person. So that is in some cash you need. And also, people like to bargain with street vendors. On the street, the Rolex watch starting from $5 per piece. After you bargain with them, $3 per piece. If you give them $100, you end up with 33 Rolex. They don't give you change. Even if they give you change, they might give you some fake money. Even could be like Taiwanese money, which is only 20% of Chinese money is value. So give them exactly money after you bargain with them. We recommend all people take some 1, some 5, some 10, some 20. You don't need any bill more than 20. So $500 of the smaller bills. Put it in the 2 separate places. Don't put all the money in one place. And that is, I have a customer, five years ago, she put all her $500 here. Then when she used the restroom, hang the neck wallet, never see the wallet again. So, me, 2 separate plates, $500 to $600 cash with you. Then Visa Master credit card. How much cash we need to change to the Chinese money? $50 to $100 change to the Chinese money. You can buy like a Diet Coke or something in the 7-Eleven, or you can buy a call taxi on the outside or something. But some the street vendor like your US dollar. Even the big government factory shop, they also accept the US dollar cash or something. That's why we recommend $500-$600 plus 1 Visa Master credit card. You too can take a second credit card, like an American Express Discover card, as your second credit card. Make sure you call your credit card company before you go. Let them to know which day you enter China, which day you come back. You don't want any Chinese people spend money after you come back. Or sometimes you might block your card as well. You think your card gets stolen. So make sure you call them, let them know which day in China, which day you come back. Same thing with ATM card. ATM machine available, airport, hotel. The street ATM not working with your ATM card. Airport, hotel one. So call your bank, call your ATM card company before you go. Let them to know which day in China, which day you come back. Airport or hotel. But they only get you the Chinese money. No US dollar, no your money. They'll give you the Chinese money. Clear? Okay. And also, all the hotels, they are hire dryers. Although Peter don't need it, but all the hotels, they are hire dryers. So you don't have to take your own. They are 220 volt. I don't know, you have 110 here, like the US, right? 110 here. So you need to be careful. So that is a doctor and a converter, European sale. You go to eBay or Amazon, tell them European sale, like $15 something, you can buy a converter and adapter. Adapter is a plug to the wall. Converter is a convert, 2010, to your computer, like something, stuff you need. Barely for the mass shaver, is sometimes is different. But all the iPod product is okay, iPhone, iPad. I actually encourage you to take an iPhone, iPad with you. Download like 10 movies. You can watch your own airplane movie. Sometimes not updated. I don't like the airplane movie at all. Okay. And then anything else I want to share with you? Money, I already told you. Electricity to the you. Tips to the you. No shot. No shot repair. So, but I still want you to see your doctor to get some antibiotic medicine. Or anti-diarrhea medicine, even to be like some sleeping pills. You never know what you need to be prepared. Okay. And another thing I want to share with you: longest bus ride. I already told you. Longest walk.
What was the longest bus ride?
Longest bus, D5, D6, D7. 1.5 hours, 2.5 hours, 3 hours, 3.5 hours to 3 hours to 3.5 hours. D5, D6, D7. Okay, the longest walk. People always assume that it's a Great Wall. We park in the downstairs of the Great Wall. I climb three stairs. I take my picture. I climb the Great Wall. I buy a T-shirt. I climb the Great Wall T-shirt. Okay, that's all I do. I climb the Great Wall. But some of you want to climb all the way up, 900 steps. Some step taller than your chair. Make sure you can come back before you go up. Actually, come down is harder than going up. You have to bend your knee very hard. So, Great Wall not designed for you to climb. Great Wall is defending function. You have a hard way or hardest way. Even harder. So, hard way or hardest way. So, two choices. You can make your own choice. I mean, you will be same happiness like the people climbed all the way to the top. Do not try too hard. Why? I have a customer, I think at least he's from Canada. He might from Yellowknife. He has two-time heart, open heart surgery. One kidney removed, little bit of lung removed. First day, he climbed to the second last to tower. Next day, he ended up in the hospital for 11 days. He didn't come back with us. So, since could have, you know the health condition better than we do. So, don't try too hard. I mean, you will let your friend have your camera. Let them take a picture for you up there. You are full do all you know. You'll be all happy, drink a tea, drink a coffee. You'll see them climbing in the picture. You will enjoy as much as they enjoy. Yeah? Clear? Okay, good. And the longest walk is the Forbidden City and the Tiananmen Square. About 3 miles. 5 kilometers walking. So we're not like army stop here and there to show you what this, what that. This is Ampere get married, this room. Ampere give test. We will give you 5-10 minutes to look around to see so you can rest and for the 5 minutes. Some of you cannot walk very far. I recommend you get a king, have a chair on. You can sit with your own chair. Or some of the seniors, we recommend we arrange a wheelchair from the Chinese people, like $70, $100, they can push you the whole way. This is the hardest part. Why? Other place, like same door in, same door out. He's all poor guy, I don't want to come back. I want to join them for the ballroom dancing. Pick me up, then you come back this way. It's okay. But Tiananmen Square, Forbidden City, Tiananmen Square, you can't turn back. You're not terrorist. After you enter Forbidden City, they don't allow you to turn back to Tiananmen Square. You have to walk with us all the way to the north end of the Forbidden City. That's why, five kilometer walking. Okay? I think I finished everything already. Any questions?
What?
Internet in China is a hotel always have a free internet in the lobby. Hotel room, they might charge you $20, $30 for the use in hotel room. Lobby always free. But they block the Facebook, they block the Gmail, Google, so they illegal in China.
You
need to buy SIM cards. Oh, you don't need to buy SIM card in China. I don't think they allow you to buy SIM card. They need a Chinese ID to buy SIM card. Regulated by the law. What's your question? Yeah, I see
there's five or six factories listed on this trip, and I've taken tours in the past where the tour bus stops and you have to be there for an hour or two. How many of those are on this trip?
I mean, how many of you read? You will see the Jade Factory in Beijing. You will see the Chloe Factory in Beijing. A poor place in Beijing. And you'll see the Silk Factory in Suzhou. Silk embroidery and the silk carpet factory in Shanghai, then the tea plantation in Hangzhou. Nobody forced you to buy anything there. Okay? Buy only if you need it. If you don't want to buy, you can walk away, stay outside. It's okay. Don't need to be there. Nobody forced you. But only three reasons to buy something in a foreign country. First, you have to have it. Some people buy a $10,000 silk embroidery, like a pure art, like as good as a painting. A piece of silk, the embroidery for like 10 months. You know, I can tell you, my mom's salary $500 to $800 a month. So for them, salary already $5,000 to $8,000. They will selling you more than $10,000 for the masterpiece silk embroidery. It's like unbelievable, as good as a painting. So we lost the skilled worker. Like when I was a kid for the Chinese New Year, we have all the paper cutting all over windows. Not anymore, we lost the skilled worker. But they don't make good money. For the new worker, your silk embroidery product, nobody wants to buy your silk. Not real. So they want to buy the master one. So we lost the young worker. They rather make iPhone for you in the iPhone factory, make $500, $800. So like, this is already dead art. So you, if you go to China, maybe 30 years later, no more artists we have for the silk embroidery, all the silk carpet anymore. So very, you know, very unfortunate. They don't make good money. That's why we lost them already. And then, second reason, you buy a gift for your friend, you buy it. Third reason, you buy a souvenir to remember the trip you buy it. I think that is, you know, for a shopping place, it's not like a shopping. For you, it's like a Chinese, you know, history, Chinese, you know, the tradition, that the silk, that, you know, the tea, you know, it's all the Chinese tradition. You don't have to buy anything. Just listen to them, give you a presentation, take a picture with a beautiful big jade. It's a very amazing thing to, for you to understand the Chinese culture, okay? Any other questions?
Question?
Yeah, go ahead.
When is it that you have to have the passport, and how long do you keep them?
So last month, either October, either September 6th or September 16th, I need the passport from you.
And when do you send them?
Was the same day. After we receive it, we bring to the Chinese Consulate General that day, or the tour visa only good for a month. I'm not very sure it's the first day or the last day of the month. So that means we need either the September 6th or September 16th. And then after we let them to see your passport, we mail you back. And also we do need to collect one of your passport size photo. Don't have to match with your passport. Passport size photo, okay?
So what's the maximum period you have the passport for?
We will only travel for like less than a week. Like I told you, we will tell you which day we will have the passport. Then we will tell you which day we need. But either on the September 6th or September 16th, that day we need your passport. So, but it must be a Monday through Thursday, Monday through Friday. So
Is there any other way to get this visa?
You can do it yourself. I mean,
but there's a Chinese embassy in Jamaica.
Oh yeah,
you can
go there to ask them if it, but you need to make a fake ticket. You need to make a ticket before you to go, and you need to make a hotel reservation. You tell them you go there.
Okay,
and
so you have to go and print off Google or
Expedia. And you have to be there two times. Because one to drop it in and waiting for 4 working days to get it back.
Okay, but that's better than
you can do that yourself. You can
Does it matter what
I think it's the same. We will do the group visa for you. We all collect.
It doesn't matter which passport.
I think that is the idea. I'm not very sure. Look, this is very new to us as well. First time I'm working with you, so we need to work things out. We need to step by step.
Are there any restrictions for Jamaicans or?
I think it's the same.
Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, so this is my first time too. My first time here too. We will next year I know better. Sorry. Beijing to Xi'an about 1 hour 40 minutes flight. 1 hour 30 minutes flight time. Okay.
I just want to clarify because I think I'm still misunderstood. So 1 month before the trip, we have to get you the passport.
Yes.
And you keep it for 1 week.
No, we keep less than 1 week. Because in the mail to us, we keep it the same day. We give it to the Chinese Consulate General, they check, they give you back. They don't do anything on it. They have a group visa, but they just need to check the passport.
But
make
when
sure.
You say we, do you mean you in California?
Yeah, we are in
so
California.
We have to give it to the
chamber mail you as a group. So far, UPS FedEx lost 6 passports during the past since 1999, so in the past 18 years, they lost 6 passports. Why they lost it? Single passport, very easy. So they mail a bunch, we never lost it. So one single passport sometimes slip away. So mail as a whole, a package, FedEx or UPS. They don't trust the post office, they use FedEx or UPS. What's your question?
And then once you got the visa, it's only valid for four weeks.
I don't know if the first day or the last day you have, but it's only good for a month. I need
that's
the month. Yeah.
Does the visa allow you multiple entries in any month?
No, I don't think so. It's only one.
Entry?
It's group in, group out. If you think only if you have it. Sorry, no more. Happy birthday to you.
If I wanted to add Hong Kong to this trip.
Sorry, you cannot add Hong Kong unless you have an individual visa. Group in, group out. If you not live with the group, the Chinese consulate, they don't let you come back. They let the group come in, group come back. Okay? Any other questions? Okay.
About how many people per tour guide?
25 to 30 people per tour guide. But the most we put on each bus, 35 people. 36 people, we will divide you to 2 buses. But the regular size, 25 to 30. We believe we need a two seats for each person.
Go ahead.
Sorry, just one more point on the passport thing. Do we give our passports to the chamber?
Yes.
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 Everybody said that. Said
You said there were 80 seats currently reserved
for that flight. For that particular
on one flight.
Yeah, one flight.
Okay. Now, are those all economy reservations?
Yeah, all economy reservations. You can pay $6,000 upgrade to a business class.
But none of those are reserved.
No, if you pay us money, we reserve for you. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You already have it. They will reserve until certain days.
Yeah. Do this every year.
Every season, 2 years.
And just one more thing about the weather, because you said you want you to layer.
Yes.
I missed that part, but I'm guessing
Beijing,
it's going to be very cold.
Beijing, like New York City. It could be cooler. One year, I said, Beijing still snow end of October. So things could happen. Dress in layers. Peter traveling today. I have my North Face rain proof jacket. So that is something you want to do. You buy a North Face jacket. Any other
question?
Go ahead.
The air quality.
Oh, air quality, good question. Starting from 3.5 years ago, air quality in Beijing and Xi'an have a problem. Suzhou, Hangzhou, Shanghai, no problem. Beijing or Xi'an have a problem. Usually winter more severe. They burn coal instead of natural gas, we use it here. That's why they are doing winter more severe. But the Beijing have a build, first we have a lot of car. Do remember like 20 some years ago, 30 years ago, we call ourselves kingdom of bicycle, not anymore. We are kingdom of car now. We have worse traffic in Beijing than New York City. Yeah, more traffic in so lot of car in there. Second one is we have the gasoline not purified here, so we not go good quality gasoline. Third thing is we have the burn coals, and also another thing is the city next to Beijing, we call Tangshan. They're heavy industrialized city. Their steel plant, their coal mining is all there in Tangshan. So when the wind blew the pollution this way, nothing Peter can do. I cannot promise you get a good weather. I mean, that's something I can, but I think the majority day we have a good weather. But if you worry about the air quality, I recommend you get 6 masks just in case. If you need it, you have the mask with you. And people say, oh, if the pollution day, I just can buy mask in the 7-Eleven in China. Remember how many people in Beijing, Peter, told you? 21, 22 million people. If the pollution day, they sold out before you get there. They sold out already. Be prepared. If you worry, you get 6 masks just in case you have it. Any other question? Go ahead. Not anyone need to go. This is a group tour.
Okay.
If we sold out that 86, we might open a date the same week, like a few days early or a few days later. Even could be the same day. If no other chamber ticket, we will give it to you. You try to let you do the same day flight, different itinerary. Okay? What's your question?
I believe the question was asked before, but the answer was still unclear to me. What are the passport requirements to travel to China?
You need your passport plus a visa, Chinese visa. But we try to do a group visa for you.
So does it matter your nationality?
She's asking if there's any banned countries.
I don't think it's any banned country. I don't know. But anyway, we will work with you individually. Ask the chamber, email us, we will give you answer from the Chinese company general email
manager.
Okay, any other question? Okay, thank you very much for coming. Thank you.
There were a couple of things I also wanted to clarify. I want to make sure that everybody got the registration form. It is one registration form per person, so it's not per family, per person. And second of all, we will be taking care of your flights from here to New York City. And you had mentioned the change in dates. That was because we have to get from here to JFK before their flights, the Chinese flights take off. And there just was no way that we could do it on the same day, so we have to come up the day before and then stay in the hotel, which we will arrange also.
I think if your friend not come over from here, I still recommend them to themselves to come over to the JFK 1 day ahead of schedule.
Okay.
We have 10 people every season late for a day because of connecting flight. Or they leave the passport in the home copy machine. They bring the old passport instead of new passport.
Just one last thing is the just to clarify, because I think some people might be mistaken too, be sure that you have the U.S. visa, right?
Well, that was my next thing. It's going to be up to you separately or to get your U.S. visa. And it can't be a visa waiver. Apparently, it has to be a B1, B2. Because you've got to go in, and then leave, and then come back in, and then go.
Well, you're talking about Vanessa.
I have no idea what that is. We're working with a local travel agency to help us with all of this part, getting all of y'all back up to New York into the hotel, and then on the way back from JFK to the hotel, and then back from the hotel back to JFK.
If I use a Cayman passport to get my China visa to get into China, my travel to and from America doesn't need to be on the same passport that has a visa, right?
No.
That's correct.
No.
Okay.
No.
You can enter on a U.S. passport.
Right. So I could give them,
yes.
You guys a Cayman passport to get a visa.
They will ask you, how do you get to U.S.? Yes, you have to give us how do you get to U.S.
So what do you need from that? Do you need a photocopy of the other passport?
No, I need the one, which one valid in U.S. to get the Chinese.
Did you get that now?
Excuse me, just a minute. When is it that everyone has to deliver their passport to the chamber?
Okay, I will let you know. Once I get the your applications and your filled out applications, okay? And I'm going to be letting everybody know, the same people that were on, that everybody who registered here today, I'm going to let you know what the next steps are and specific dates and things like that.
And also, if we have more than 30 people or more, chamber will send a representative to be with you.
No, I think we're going to send somebody
else.
But we just want to, we need to know who's going to be coming. So there is going to be a deadline to fill out your forms and give your deposit in. And then after that, we will go through the timeline and we will let you know specifically when we need your passport by, when we need this by, and you would pay us, and we would take the money and distribute it to everywhere that it's got to go.
So the visa has to have a start date just prior to the 6th, right?
Yeah. Either the 6th or the 16th. Because the visa only good for a month.
No,
I don't know if the first day include or the last day include. So I need to make sure. I know that, then I let you know which day. Either September 6th or September 16th, I need to give your visa to the Chinese County General in Los Angeles.
Do you have the date of the cutoff that you
will
be taking more applications? Do you have that date?
Like I told you, we only have 80 seats. First come, first serve. After we sold out 80, we will tell you more. If we get one more flight, which day or same day, we will let you know. Okay?
You mentioned buying travel insurance, but it says here it's included.
No. It's only included for the U.S. passport holder. Not included for the Cayman Islands. So all insurance companies don't include anything happened before. It only includes the very basic things for the U.S. passport holder. It's all good.
So if you have a U.S. passport, it's included?
It's included, but
yes.
You guys from this chamber probably not, because we need everybody from U.S. to do the U.S.
So how much is it?
It's $150, $200, $250. It depends on your age, depend on, I know based on the US, so we can buy from a AAA. We can buy from a AAA, yeah.
So we should budget $250 for the insurance.
$150 to $250, depends, yeah.
My insurance company here offers travel insurance.
Yes, of course. Yes. You buy your own. You don't buy from Peter. You buy your own.
Yeah.
Yeah, if we have individual questions, you can always ask the chamber. If chamber cannot answer, we will answer it within 24 hours. You know, email us, you know, email back to them on the within 24 hours.
So I know this sounds like we're just a broken record, okay? But it's very nerve-wracking to give anybody their passport when they live on an island.
I mean, you can't wait until next year. That my whole friend will be here. This is the only choice. Yeah. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you.
Thank you.